Hello, everybody. Welcome to Morning English. This is Leona.
Morning, guys. This is Blair.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Wow, she's so talented and creative. 怎么有这么有才的人呢？
So, who are you talking about?
Have you followed Poppy Jiang?
Yeah, of course. Each of her video can make me laugh and think deeply at the same time.
Yes, she's a genius. 她真的太有才了、mm. 但是她的一些个人的观点和做法有时候也会引起一些争议。
对、mm. 比如说啊，她最近的一次采访里面提到她把小孩送到托管班，哎，这件事呢就被大家骂了。
啊 How old is her son?
Like 15 months old, something?、Mm. 就一岁三个月吧好像。
But actually, it's ordinary right now. If both she and her husband are busy on their work, it's a good choice.
Yes. Well, someone thinks that it's better for kids if their mom could raise them at least by three.、Mm. 就有些人会觉得、啊、如果三岁前妈妈能够亲自带小孩，哎，这对小孩来说才是最好的。
Is it the law that all of mothers have to obey? 这妈妈也要有自己的工作和生活呀。
哎，对呀、啊 mm. It's tough, especially for working mother at present.、
Mm, true. I think we should speak up for those working mothers and let others know more about them.
Agree. 那我们今天就来聊一聊、啊、和职业妈妈、职场妈妈相关的一些话题。
As Michelle said when she won the Academy Awards, all the mothers in the world are the superheroes.
嗯，
杨紫琼在奥斯卡的获奖感言上不也说了吗、
嗯、
无论是全职妈妈还是我们说的职场妈妈都是我们的超级英雄。
Absolutely, they give birth to us. 孕育生命就是本身就是一件非常伟大的事了。
Right, 所以生孩子我们可以用 give birth 来表达哈。最近有一个朋友啊，她还生了一对双胞胎呢。
嗯、
She gave birth to twins.
Congratulations.Give birth 当然不仅可以用来指人类生孩子啊，动物产崽也是一样的、
嗯、
比如说我室友的猫咪昨天夜里呢就把自己的崽那个生下来了Her cat gave birth last night、
嗯、其实无论是谁啊，迎接新生命都是一件令人很欣喜的事情、
right.
But most of time, mothers have to be faced with questions especially when you choose to return to paid work
的确是这样、
嗯、
孩子出生以后呢，妈妈们面对的问题就会来自于像各种亲戚朋友啊、
嗯、
Such as, who's going to raise the kids. What about breastfeeding? Or how are you going to make it home for dinner?
唉，就是生孩子只是一个开始啊，怎么样去抚养孩子才是需要花更多时间的一个课题。So raise the kids. Raise 在这里就是抚养、养育的意思。And you must know the song, You Raise Me Up.
Yeah,
对吧？这首歌大家都听过哈、
right.
就是抚养我长大嘛。
Raise the kids 在美式英语当中用的比较多啊、
嗯、
英式英语当中呢用的是 bring up 像我们这一代人其实很多是被爷爷奶奶带大的就可以说 I was brought up by my grandmother、
嗯、那对于妈妈们来说、啊、现实的情况还有更多琐碎的事情 And for working mothers their pressure doesn't only come from their family but also the office
Exactly 职场也是很现实的尤其是对妈妈们来说、
嗯、
Because of gendered expectation of women's caregiving responsibilities peers andmanagers assume moms will put their careers on the back burner.
Stuck in the dilemma, 真的是进退两难哈。家人觉得你陪孩子少了，但领导反而会怕你为了看孩子把工作放到一旁了。
Yes, so here, put on the back burner, 意思就是把什么什么呢搁置一旁。
嗯，很有意思的一个表达哈。So burner、嗯、其实就是燃烧器呀、啊，或者我们更通俗一些的来讲就是炉子嘛。
对，炉子。
你把什么东西放在靠后的炉子上了，那不就是也不是很着急，不是很重要的意思。
对，嗯、比如说我这周计划出去玩啊，但奈何。突然来了个工作 So I have to put my plans on the back burner for a while
Just temporarily 只是暂时的啦咱们延迟满足吗
希望是的啊
但是也希望职场妈妈们不要因此把自己放到不重要的位置上了 You can't put yourself on the back burner
Right 因为职场妈妈在这样的刻板偏见的误解下其实会受到很多的不公平待遇、
嗯
The employers might give them fewer opportunities or project, devalue their work, or judge them for dugging out early to pick up their kids.
哇， ducking out to pick up their kids. So poor.
Yeah.
但是 duck out 这个表达也很生动啊，它的意思就是表示逃走、逃避。但是妈妈们绝对不是故意的要去逃避工作哈，就像我们刚才说的，两者难两全呀。
对，但是家庭环境下还真的是会有 duck out 这种情况出现。比如说前两天啊，我妈还吐槽我爸呢。It's his turn to cook dinner, but I bet he'll try to duck out of it.
So cute. 所以逃避什么事情，我们可以说 duck out of something.
Yeah.
But you can't duck out of your responsibilities.
没错。
自己的责任还只是绝对不能逃避的啊。
But what I want to tell those mothers is that please don't try to figure it all out at once. 妈妈们啊，也不需要给自己太大的压力，要解决所有的问题。
没错 ,figure out 在这里就表示解决问题的意思，当然也有想明白的意思哈，比如说很多的男生啊，在女朋友生气的时候怎么想都想不明白他到底
想不通啊，
哎，对，怎么了，为什么生气啊， I can't figure out why she got angry，
女孩的心思就别猜了女孩的心思猜不透，那数学题能做对吗？figure out 还可以用来表示算出问题的答案这个意思，like can you figure out the answer to the question？
那如果生活的难题还真的解决不了的话呢， For working mothers, I think they need to reach out for help, even if help looks like talking to someone, watching the kids, or finding ways to relax yourself. 妈妈们是可以求助的啊，要给自己留出一些自己的时间。
Reach out for help, 在这里意思就是寻求帮助嘛。Reach out for something, 本身有伸手去够这个意思。For example, I tried to reach out for my glass of water, forgetting that I had left it in the kitchen.
很熟悉的画面啊，我也是经常犯这种迷惑。Reach out, 另外一个非常常用的意思可以表示联系某人。Reach out to somebody. 比如说我们早安英文有各种课程发布啦。So many people reached out to us.
随时欢迎大家啊。那对于那些职场妈妈来说呢，就很需要有一个朋友跟他们说 You can always reach out to me if you are feeling unhappy.
Yes, that means a lot to them. 真的，哪怕只是这一句话来说对他们也很重要，
所以妈妈们啊，也希望你们能够放轻松 Go easy on yourself.
Exactly. So go easy on someone means to treat someone in a gentle way. 温柔的宽容的对待一个人。
对，比如妈妈们有时候实在是这个脾气上来了，着急了，对孩子很凶，事后呢可能都会很后悔啊。I should have gone easy on her because she didn't mean to do that.
哎，没错。那这个呢是我们后面加人啊，用在 someone 的时候。 Go easy on something refers to not take or use too much of something. 对什么东西要有节制一些。
对，像每次去医院，医生一般都会告诫就是要忌口啊，少吃辛辣食物。 The doctor told me to go easy on the spicy food for a while.
So take care of yourself, everybody. 我们每个人啊都要照顾好自己。
没错。
And we need to go easy on our mom.对自己的妈妈哈也要多体谅一些。
Yes. Hope all of you guys enjoying today's podcast and welcome to leave your comments.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Okay, so time to say goodbye. This is Blair.
This is Leona. See you next time.
Bye! Bye.